We got chest and tricep today with the Black Prince of Bodybuilding, Mr. Robby Robinson. We're back in the Iron Disneyland, Gold's Venice, the Mecca.
That's me. Some people do less.
Yes.
12, 15.
This is the grip, this wide. Chest up, arch.
Mm-hmm. Feet pressed into the floor, so that gives you a thing. And the hands should come back over there. There
here.
You go. Right there. No. There.
Here.
Right there.
Mm-hmm.
Now you're in the box.
Right
up, and then you squeeze the pecs. There's two of them. There's three of them. I drop back down in the seat. I keep going back to the same thing, see? No, I don't care how much the weight is. I'm going back to the same thing, the same method. You see what I'm saying? You don't change it, and all of a sudden, you're doing something different. So that way, the body gets, the muscles get used to that system. I come up here. I know exactly where my elbows are. Boom, that weight has to move.
So it's almost like you're contracted
yeah,
in a way.
Yeah, automatically. Go up into it. It's automatic, you see? That way, the pecs are going to carry the load. Two.
On the top of the movement, Robby, do you extend all the way out
no,
or you just
no,
squeeze
just,
the chest?
I keep the elbows slightly
always
bent
like
at the top. You have to mentally contract that muscle and physically contract that muscle at the same time.
So always constant tension.
Constant tension, yeah.
So you're starting from here and you slide into it.
Mm-hmm. You slide into it and go into an upper back arch.
Yep.
That's what you do. Pressing your feet into the floor. You're right there in it. It's one of them. Don't lock it out. Two of them. Squeeze the pecs mentally and physically. Three of them. There's four of them. Let it stretch a little bit more. Yeah, five of them. There you go. So you'll go back to that, see? Six of them. Seven of them. See, that makes it harder when you're doing it. It's eight of them. Squeeze. It's nine of them. It's 10 of them.
Mm-hmm. It's like a choreography. You kind of like dance.
It is
with
a choreography. That's what it is. Bodybuilding is not just going in and lifting the damn weight.
Yeah.
It's, you have to have the right body position. The body has to be in the right position for you to build muscle. If you see some people have a huge tricep, but there's no shape. You
that's
ever see?
Fine.
Okay, there you go. They're not even connecting to that muscle. They just do an exercise.
Yeah.
And just that's
they're
waste of time
dancing,
and energy.
The
yeah.
dance is wrong.
Yeah,
the
and it's
are wrong.
Yeah, it's just too long. If you take the time, sit down on this bench, I know exactly where everything is. My feet are pressed into the floor. That's my power. If my feet are up like this, you have no power. That's what I see everybody doing. You have to press your feet into the floor.
The whole foot,
yeah,
not
yeah,
just
yeah,
like the heel.
Yeah.
Toes too.
Yeah. I lay my body back down here. I come here and look, find where my hands are. Once I find where my hands are, I automatically butt the chest. The chest is right on my, all the stress is on my pec. All I got to do is roll my hands forward, keep my chest up, inhale, one of them. Two. Three of them. Put your hands on my pecs, you see what I'm doing. Four.
Oh yeah.
There you go, see?
Upper chest.
Two. Every time it's doing the same thing. Six. Two. Two.
And it's all upper chest.
Two. Exactly.
Is there a reason why you do
what?
You always start with upper or just today? Do you
what?
Always start with upper chest incline?
No, I go back and forth.
A lot of people are missing the upper chest.
Right. Yeah.
So
because what they're doing is they you're not criticizing.
Yeah.
You just don't have a cue for their body's in the right position.
Got
they
it.
Don't have it. It's not there.
Got it. And it's almost like the way you slide in, I just had a little moment there. It's almost like power lifting when they do the bench press.
Yeah.
It's almost like but you get into it from a bodybuilding perspective. You set it in.
You set it in. Exactly.
Instead of just exploding
yeah,
it
just,
for
it's
one
part, rep. It's right there.
Got it.
There you go. That's one of them. There's two, nope, you're going back to your old side.
Yep.
There's three of them. There's four of them. Get it back over here. Five of them. There you go, see? You get back over here. Six of them. Twist with the elbows and squeeze. Seven of them. Push the feet into the floor, get your power. A double C, press your feet into the floor, you get power. See there? There you go. You get, push your feet into the floor. Awesome. You,
oh,
see what, you see what I'm saying?
I forgot the feet.
Yep. See, the more you press your feet into the floor, you're going to get power.
Wow.
It's automatic. You can't help it.
I can talk
about it till I drop, bro.
I'm so focused on the upper body that I forget about
exactly. You see guys with the feet up like this here. You got, they someone have 500 pounds on there. That muscle, first you're going to do, you're going to want to injure yourself.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because it has no power base. If you came and kick my, come and move my foot, you'll see what I'm talking about. Do it to my feet.
Yep.
And you'll see what I'm talking about. The power. This is your power. It's a base.
Got
you
it.
Have to use that base.
It blows my mind because I've been lifting for 40 years with the feet, not even thinking about it. It's all upper body.
Yeah.
Wow.
You see, that drives the muscle. Because now, boom, I got a power base. Push my foot. It's not going to move. That's what I'm saying. And even when I'm pressing, I'm forcing my feet to be in that floor.
Wow.
Heavy. Last set. See, low reps. See, one more.
Wow.
See.
Beautiful.
Boom.
Wow. So I just learned that the body is basically a whole unit. You ground it from the feet up, and if you don't have the feet planted, you're missing like half of the work. It's so much more powerful when you actually use the feet. Once you ground it, you build from the bottom to the top. Mind blown.
There's four of them. Keep your chest up. Five of them. Keep pushing with the elbow. Keep pushing with the elbow. Don't be doing anything. Six of them. Keep pushing with the elbow. Keep pushing with the elbow. You're going back to your old style. Awesome.
It's almost like it's overwhelming for my brain to think feet, chest, elbows,
yeah.
Breathing.
But see, that's because you're not used to it.
Yes.
But it's something that I would say practice.
Yes.
It's a practice. That's what it is.
Repetitions.
Yeah. It's a complete difference in what, you know, everybody else is doing. You're not trying to do that, but that's how I've never had an injury. That's why I've never had any
kind
of thing. That's right.
You're like one of the only ones who've never been injured.
Never been injured. I have never had an injury, back, leg, or shoulder, elbow, knee, nothing.
Amazing.
Because it's all body positioning. Everything I do, when I come and squat, boom, that's my base. I can't be moved. Push my foot. I'm digging into that foot. I won't move that foot.
Yeah.
It's all power. Boom, I'm right there on it. Boom, I'm in my body. 500 pounds, 600 pounds. Because I'm on the floor, I'm using this as my base, this is my power, I push off the floor. That's what is happening.
Wow.
I'm like an artist in it, man. That's what I'm.
You are an artist.
And the other way around, I couldn't do it the way the guys are doing it. That's the way they do, they think it's worth it. I don't use his own. But you're not gonna last long who fit with being.
So I consider myself an artist in music, because I make music.
Mm-hmm.
And my wife's an artist,
mm-hmm.
and I'm a developing artist in this. We're shaping the body.
Oh, yeah.
And one thing that I came to in a moment of flow, I was
mm-hmm.
in the zone,
mm-hmm.
it came to me and it was, you cannot rush art.
You can't.
You cannot rush art. How do you rush art?
And bang, go to do those pieces.
Yeah. You take all the time you need.
Yeah, you take whether the time to make it.
Whether it's 42,
yeah.
whether it's 76,
yeah.
you're still painting.
Yeah.
You're still
painting that body. Yep, that's exactly what I'm doing. Good changes to go into bench press.
So you're doing the same thing. You position yourself, shoulder blades.
Put your hands on my back.
On your back.
Okay. That part of your back should be buried into that bench. That's your brace.
Got it.
The bench is your base. My feet should be on the floor, pressing into the floor. Whatever weight that I move, it's in that angle. It's all on my upper, all on my pecs. One of them. Feel my pecs. Two. Three of them. Four. Five of them. Six. Seven of them. Eight.
So I've had problems in the past with my shoulders, because I was probably going too low. I would drop the bar all the way down to my neck.
Yeah, because the minute you go like this,
yeah,
it's all tendons up in there.
Yes.
Okay.
Rotator
the elbow.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying? So they eventually start to become sore and irritated,
like
and start to splinter.
Overextended a little bit.
What?
Overextended.
Overextended. Yeah. You want to keep that. The weight should be, from your weight is at the top and at the bottom, it should be a continuous tension of weight on that muscle.
This way you're only working the muscle and you're not working the joint.
Sure.
Because this is not joint building, it's muscle building.
It's muscle building. I mean, you know, it was like, I'll show you exactly what, just cut a minute, Ronnie. This is what Ronnie did. He went like this.
Uh-huh.
Bounce. The minute he bounced, that bird of it on the right side went. And the guy that was working with him said, Ronnie said, what was that? And the guy said, what was what? But the bird of it had already crushed.
Wow.
Keep that elbow right there, right there. That's where you want to be, one of them.
Mm-hmm.
It's two of them, don't overextend it. Right there. There's three of them.
Mm-hmm.
Squeeze the pecs. There's four of them. You don't have to overextend it. Right there. Five of them. That weight should be pressing down on that muscle. Six of them. Push with the elbows and squeeze. Seven of them. Push with the elbows and squeeze. Eight of them. Push with the elbows and squeeze. Push with the elbows and squeeze. Push with the elbows and squeeze.
Wow. Wow.
That's what you want to do consistently. That weight should be constantly pressing down on that muscle. If a lot of people, they get up here and they go like this. You rest.
Have you seen the product Slingshot that helps the power lifter? It's like this rubber thing that helps him explode up.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like my chest was a slingshot right now.
Exactly.
Instead of an extra piece of equipment,
mm-hmm.
it was my chest that was like ready to spring.
That's what it is. You're trying to push up on. That's exactly what you're doing.
Wow.
In my mind, I get more adamant about correct form and technique. I'm gonna come here, I'm gonna find out exactly where my hands are. I'm gonna go right back to that position, putting my butt into the bench, pressing my feet into the floor. Everything should be about parallel. I roll it on the end of my hand. It's all right there, man. Two. Awesome.
The feeling I get is the whole body is as one, but the main focus is the chest.
Exactly.
Everything is connected,
exactly.
Grounded,
exactly.
But the culmination is right here.
Mm-hmm. Come on, Sam. Come on now.
For full development, incline, flat,
three,
and maybe flies or
my next exercise would be flies.
Got it.
Yeah, cable flies or dumbbell, preferably the dumbbell flies. That would be the next one.
But I totally feel how everything is filled up now.
There you go. Because you're in the right position, the muscles are doing the work. You're constantly keeping stress on that muscle so it can grow. That's how it grows. It can't grow otherwise. You see, back in the day, in the old days. We started with 65, the next weight was 45,
yeah.
And the next weight was 40, or 35. In those times, when you're going like about 2 weeks before the competition, everything is supersetted. I mean, you go a set of chest, set of back, through probably four different exercises. And you do the same thing with biceps, set of triceps, set of back, set of triceps, set of biceps, set of triceps, set of biceps, back and forth like that. hour, 45 minutes, 2 hours, according to how you're feeling. Dumbbell fly. It's like you got your chest again buried into that bench. You open that chest up slowly, slowly. So all the pressure's kept on the plate. You push with the elbow and squat off them. Two. Three of them. Two. Two of them. Six. Seven of them. Eight. Bring my knees up. When you go like that, it contracts the pecs.
Makes sense.
Boom, you stand right up and hit a side chair shot. That's what you would do. Smiling.
Yeah. So I was watching Pumping Iron the other day,
mm-hmm.
and Franco was posing.
You know, yeah.
And he goes into the side chest pose, and Arlo goes, Franco, if you don't have it, don't hit it.
There you go.
He was messing with him.
Oh yeah, always. Let it come across it, but no, you gotta keep the elbow slightly bent.
Oh.
Okay.
Like this?
Yeah, better than that.
Here?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And now?
One of them, push with the elbow, see? You gotta push with the elbow. You gotta push with the elbow. There's two of them. You gotta squeeze my hand. Come on. There's three of them. Inhale, exhale, the same thing. There's four of them. Stronger than me. Five of them. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Six of them. Inhale, exhale. There's seven of them. Squeeze the pecs, squeeze the pecs. Eight of them. Mm-hmm. Stronger than me. There's nine of them. Get them up there. Inhale, exhale. This is the one that counts. The rest of them didn't count. You're on your own. Put it down.
Chest is getting pumped up.
Come on, I said. Come on, I said. Press that back, upper back into the bench. Yep.
So, starting here.
You gotta open, you gotta keep them like that.
Okay.
Like here. That. There you go. Now you're in it. Push. There's one of them. Come on, come on. There's two of them. Push off your base. There's three of them. You gotta get it closer together. Four. Yeah. Five of them. Go keep your body down now. Keep that body down. Six of them. Seven of them. Inhale, exhale. Eight of them. You're starting to fail. You gotta get it up. You gotta get it up. You gotta get it up. You got one. This is the one that counts. The rest of them didn't count. Awesome.
The power comes almost like from the elbow. It's the elbow that's driving the chest.
You can't build a muscle, especially if you're pressing, without pushing with the elbow.
Yeah.
You know, what people try to do is they open themselves up like this and try to bring the hand together. But what you're doing, you're killing the tendons in here.
Got it.
You're killing all of that. So if you bend the elbow,
yes,
that makes the whole thing easier. My upper back is buried into that bench. When I open up my box, because that's my box, I press my back into that bench.
Oh yeah.
Each time.
My thinking was, if I don't stretch him out all the way out, I wouldn't get the proper stretch.
No,
but the stretch is from the elbows.
Yeah, it's from the elbow.
Wow.
See, if you're doing it the way you're doing it, you're gonna more than likely tear something in there. Because you're letting the barbell go like that.
Yes.
See, when they shouldn't be done like that, so be kept locked down.
And no wonder over the years, I've been going in and out from some elbow tendonitis. And I've always been so open.
That's what it is, because see, you're so open. It's just too open. And that puts more stress on the elbow, on the tissue.
Got it.
pretty much tear your pec line.
In the back, I had it more dialed in. I learned how to pull with my elbow, but now I'm learning how to press
push,
with the
push,
elbow.
Exactly.
Wow.
I'm gonna go up in the weight again. You'll see exactly what I'm doing. You'll see I do the same exact thing. Boom. Back is into the bench. I slowly open up that box. I slowly, all the tensions on my pecs, one of them. Two. 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 I feel that all on the pecs, on. Nothing in here, nothing. That shouldn't be any stress in there.
Yes.
It should be all on your pecs.
I'm not feeling anything in my shoulder today.
There you go, exactly.
The natural instinct whenever you go heavier is to run away.
To run away.
Let's get it down.
Yeah.
Get it down faster.
Yeah.
Get out of there.
No, danger, you do it slower.
Too heavy. And you go the opposite. Like, let me actually stay in longer.
Exactly. You let the muscle carry the load, not the joints.
Just so you know, I'm super grateful to be here with you. And I'm enjoying every single moment.
Me too, it's great.
This is like, for me, it's like
yeah, because you're teaching and helping a lot of people. Like, you both are. So.
Yeah, and grateful for you as well. I'm just grateful, man.
Yeah, great.
It's, I love it.
Last one. Let me go straight to tricep. Come on. You got this. Paperweight.
So, right here?
Yep. And push. That's all you do. One of them. Come across your body. Come across your body. Yeah. Push. There you go. There you go. One of them. It's two of them. Don't bounce. Right there. Mm-hmm. Three of them. See there? There you go.
Yeah.
See? You're at that level.
Uh-huh.
Four of them. Right there.
Five.
Mm-hmm. Keep coming on down. Right there. Six. Push with the elbows and squeeze. Seven of them. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Eight. These the one you get on your own. Come on, work. There's nine of them, nine of them. This the one that count. This the one that count. The rest of them didn't count. You're on your own. Squeeze them. Awesome.
You're creating magic with magical people. My brother from another mother. Bryan Wesley Williams behind the camera. Love the shit, man. I'm like a fucking kid in a candy store. Every second of it. It's like 42 years on planet Earth leads down to this one moment. And this moment is 1 hour in my favorite place on planet Earth. The Gold Gym, Venice. I don't know if you know, maybe I said another video. Day two, moved to LA. Didn't have a place to live, but I got my membership of Golds. It's called Priorities in Life.
If you see a lot of guys don't have that hump right there.
Yeah.
But what this does, that gives you that hump. It makes that whole arm look like a piece of art. If you notice, I'm leaning back.
Yes.
Okay. You need to see where my elbows are?
Well,
the closer you, anytime you're doing a tricep exercise, the closer you hold your elbows to your ears,
uh-huh,
the more tricep you're gonna get. Okay. What people do is this.
Pull that round.
I mean, it's okay. But you're talking about massive. All three heads. The tricep has three heads, right? It don't have two. It has three heads. So the more I push my elbows together, my knuckles, you see my knuckles are together?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, that's what you have to do. Okay, so I'm kind of leaning back slightly a little bit.
Uh-huh.
One of them. Put my elbows together to my ears, two of them. It's three of them. Looking up sometime if I want to, or keeping the elbows to the ear, five of them, six, rhythm, seven of them, eight, nothing but tricep, nine of them, 10. Mm-hmm. See, when you put your elbows together, that forces the tricep to work all the way from up here all the way to the elbow. So when I throw my arm up, that should be, this little thing look like a teardrop, a comma. This is bodybuilding. This is what I'm seeing in my mind. And then I should have that little head that is right there. The long hair should be hanging. Come on. There's four of them. Get the elbows to the elbows. Five of them. Stretch the triceps. The six of them. Come on, come on, come
all
on.
All the way down?
Yeah, you go. Seven of them. Stretch that sucker. Come on. Eight of them. It should be burning now. Nine of them. It'll be good and sore tomorrow. 20.
Oh my God. I'm feeling it everywhere.
Everywhere, exactly. Put your hands behind your head like this.
Yep.
Grab my elbow.
Grab my elbow.
And what you try to do, what I'm gonna try to do is,
I'm going to
push my elbows together, lift my chest up, okay? You try to pull my elbows together. You try to pull them together.
Like this?
You have one of them. Not so hard, just easy.
Okay.
It's two of them. Let it go a little bit.
Got it.
Three. It's four of them. Five. Six. Squeeze. Seven of them. That's eight. Ooh.
Got
push
it.
The elbow. One of them.
And contract
try to resist.
Oh, wow.
Two of them. Just don't try to hold it. Let it go a little bit. Three of them.
So let you stretch me.
Push all this, squeeze all of this.
Got
there
it.
You go.
Got mm-hmm. it.
Five of them. Come on. Six of them. Let it go. Seven of them. Tell me what you feel when you get through. Eight of them. Keep the elbows together. Come on. It's nine of them. It's 10 of them. You want to have lats? Okay.
I felt a V.
There you go.
I felt a V.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I see. They think you got to use thousands. You can use it. It's okay.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with it.
Yeah.
We're talking about building muscle.
Yeah.
Shape, beauty. Two of them. I push my muscles together. The more you force your knuckles together and the elbows to the ears, the more massive you're going to be able to charge that.
So my chest, I feel like it's so pumped up that when I'm stretching
exactly.
it, I feel stretching my pec
exactly.
down.
And see, that was an exercise that we used to do back in the old days.
Like after a pullover almost. God, that's what it is. I'm like, why
that kind of
like
stuff doesn't exist anymore. They don't do that anymore. That's too old school.
All right, so lean back a little.
Get them elbows to your
together.
Head.
Right here.
And keeping them. One of them. Force your knuckles together. Two of them. There you go. Watch the difference. Three of them. The knuckles together. Four. It's five of them. Six. Get the elbows to your head. Seven of them. Get the elbows to your head. Eight. Knuckles. Nine of them. Put the knuckles together. Ten of them. You'll be good and sore tomorrow in different areas.
That's what we do this for. To be sore in the right places.
Yeah, because that's what bodybuilding is. That's what weight training should be about.
Yeah.
You see, they just don't know. They're not, I mean, say educated. They just don't have that kind of knowledge.
Totally.
It's just not there.
Like last time, we did back and bicep.
Mm-hmm.
There was zero joint pain and it was sore just back and bicep. Oh, a little bit of glutes too.
Because you're squeezing at the pull.
Oh my
exactly.
God. The glutes.
That's what you're supposed to do. It's a network of muscle.
Yeah.
So you should be focused on that network.
Yes.
Okay, you got all these muscles in your back. You got all this in your chin. And raise and arm, base and quad. So you should be focusing on all that network. Shouldn't you be just, I'm training quads. You're training quads and all the muscles in that quad.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to manifest that thought into that muscle for that muscle to grow. Bodybuilding is not, it should be at a higher grade. It is in my world.
Of course.
But, a lot of people just, they're disrespected. They do all kinds of crazy.
Yeah. Well, the whole world changed today.
Yeah, it's just changed.
The whole world
changed.
Yeah. one exercise.
Even when you're exercising whatever muscle group you're working, flex it sometimes. Flex the arm. Well, all that, what it does is it supplies the muscle with new blood. That's what it is. Creates more new capillary. I do it all.
Another thing that I like sometimes I do flex after, mm-hmm. and I establish a better connection.
Yeah.
The mind with the body.
Mind muscle connection.
And exactly. I just transfer it into the exercise.
Exactly.
But I've created already through the posing mm-hmm. and the flexing.
Exactly. This is an exercise that, what's his name? Larry Scott used to do, right?
Okay.
He would bend over, look up, mm-hmm. one of them, roll the ball up on his hands.
Two.
Three of them. Four. Put your hands on my tricep, you'll see. Five.
Oh, yeah.
Come all the way up.
Oh, wow.
You see what I'm saying? Makes it hang. Six. Seven. Seven. Looking up each time. Eight.
This is almost like a stiff arm kickback.
Exactly. He would do eight sets of eights of Scott bench, eight sets of eights of that exercise.
Wow.
Best arms in the world.
2005,
mm-hmm.
I came to America.
Okay.
My first month.
Okay.
I came to the US with $400 in my pocket. And I found
You had more than me, I had seven.
There you go. So I found out about the Olympia, it was happening that month.
Okay.
So the roommate that I started living with, mm-hmm. I asked him to borrow me some money.
Okay.
So I can go to the Olympia.
Wow.
And
you have to do that no more.
And yeah, so I went and I had money for like a couple of nights. So the last day, I didn't have money to stay anywhere.
Uh-huh.
So I slept on the airport.
Okay, that's okay.
But it was the 40th anniversary.
Mm-hmm.
So I got to meet everybody.
That's great.
And I took pictures with Larry.
Yeah, all the guys.
Sergio Lima. Because everybody was in town.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
And it was amazing. Okay, so you bent here.
You gotta flatten that back, gotta get the head up. And each one, you squeeze it up there, you gotta look over there. One of them.
Mm-hmm.
There's two of them. Roll it up on your hand. Three of them, there you go.
Yeah,
you go. Four of them. You can see the triceps, see? Five of them. It just all through heads right here. Six of them. Push. Seven of them. Come on. Eight of them. Squeeze. Nine of them. I know you feel that.
Oh.
Ten, put it down.
Wow. The little detail last time you gave me for the roll at the end for the bicep curl,
mm-hmm.
is a small detail now on the roll on the tricep.
The same thing.
Oh my gosh,
that's
like
all
a
it
small
is.
Little ending.
Yeah, I love bodybuilding like a little kid. I think I'll probably be somewhere working out and everything stopped right there, really. Push and roll it up, roll it down on your hand or roll it up on your hand. One of them, roll it down. There's two of them. Squeeze all of this. Three of them. Come on. Four. Stay down. Five of them. There you go. Six. Make the tricep do the work. Seven of them. You got a triple. Eight. Squeeze that boy. Squeeze it. It's nine. Squeeze it. Ten of them. Beautiful, man. Awesome. They would do it and they'll go like this. With the knee. With your notch. You pull the lock your knee. Press into the pole.
Yes.
Push. Roll.
It's not a leg day. It's a tricep day.
Yeah.
Batman, Scoop, SPASE! Don't think it's hard! Yeah, it's definitely hard! It's hard to stop!